Hello, my name is Natalia Dmitrieva and I'm a scientist at the National Heart, Lung and Blood Institute. I will summarize a study that my colleagues and I recently published in JCI Insight. We demonstrated that chronic hypohydration promotes age-related degenerative changes. We arrived at this conclusion based on both mouse and human data. First, we exposed mice to lifelong water restriction and analyzed their aging process. Second, we analyzed data from a 25-year clinical study to compare the prevalence of various diseases to patients' hydration habits.
Water is the main constituent of the body and is essential for homeostasis and life. Water balance is the balance between water intake and output in the body. Normally, water output is regulated to be equal to water intake. The major routes of water intake are drinking water, as well as water found in food and produced metabolically. Water is lost in urine, as well as through the skin, lung, feces, and sweat. Decreasing water intake leads to the activation of renal water conservation mechanisms. The result is the excretion of a low volume of more concentrated urine. If water intake decreases further, water output exceeds input and leads to dehydration. Dehydration can be detected by weight loss. Decreasing level of hydration are reflected in an increasing concentration of blood electrolytes and can be assessed by measuring serum osmolarity. Sodium and its accompanying anions are main electrolytes and can be used as a measure of hydration status. When serum osmolarity exceeds a threshold level around 285 milliosmol per kilogram, an antidiuretic hormone is secreted from the brain and acts on the kidney to activate water preservation mechanisms. The result is the excretion of a low volume of more concentrated urine to match decreased water input and maintain normal water balance. While water balance is maintained, we refer to this state as suboptimal hydration. In our study, we investigated how such suboptimal hydration affects long-term health outcomes. In the first part of our study, we exposed mice to lifelong water restriction by feeding them with gel food containing 30% of water. We compared these mice to well-hydrated control mice. Throughout their life, water-restricted mice consumed more food to produce metabolic water. The water restriction shortened mouse lifespans by an average of 6 months. While there were no difference in body weight during the first year of life, the growth of water-restricted mice subsequently slowed and then sharply decreased during their last weeks of life. The weight decrease was preceded by increased markers of inflammation and coagulation, as well as impaired motor coordination. Water-restricted mice also experienced accelerated renal deterioration and developed cardiac fibrosis. These results indicated that chronic water restriction accelerates degenerative changes and shortens life in a mouse model. In the second part of our study, we tested the health outcomes of different hydration levels in humans. We analyzed data from the atherosclerosis risk in community study, in which about 15,000 adults were evaluated over 5 visits spanning 25 years. We used serum sodium from visits 1 and 2 as a measure of hydration status. Based on their serum sodium concentration, we divided study participants into 4 groups and analyzed the prevalence of age-related degenerative diseases within each group 25 years later. This analysis revealed that the higher serum sodium concentrations were correlated with increased prevalence of many degenerative diseases. In particular, disease prevalence sharply increased with sodium levels above 142 millimol per liter. In this range, we found an increased prevalence of many degenerative diseases, including dementia, heart failure, chronic lung disease, chronic kidney disease, diabetes, high blood pressure, and stroke. Our analysis predicts that maintaining good hydration and keeping serum sodium below 142 millimol per liter may greatly reduce the prevalence of degenerative diseases, which may result in 3 million people not developing these diseases in the United States alone.